Hey guys, welcome to a new tutorial. In this video I want to show you how you can actually apply the warp mode bend plus minus from Serum in the grid to some random oscillator, even the new wavetable oscillator. And before we do that, I actually show you what my thinking was about it. So I'm using a wavetable, ADSR. And maybe an oscillator. Maybe you don't even need the ADSR. And of course we need some phase tools, the phaser, bend, and also another oscilloscope here. So when we see we have this wavetable here and we play some notes on the keyboard, you can see it changes, and you probably also already figured out that when you use the phaser here with the PM input and switch this to zero, you have the same effect as before. But now you can insert here a band, for instance, and can change the oscillator shape quite a bit. But what's not possible is that you actually imitate the band plus minus with some of these phase modifiers here in the grid. And for that, we need to do some kind of trick. And I want to show you this. So when we look here at the phase signal itself, we see it's just a reversed saw wave or a saw waveform. And when we apply here some bend to it, it looks like this. So it's shaped differently. And when we think about this, when we do actually apply some kind of warp mode to it, then why not, instead of using the phaser with the modifier, just use a waveform that we need? And for that, we just go to the Serum here. We actually don't need to do that. You can just download it after the video. So we go here to oscillator A and we just draw in our phase signal, which looks like this. Then we apply here the bend warp mode plus minus. You can see how the phase signal should look like, something like this. Pretty nice. And all we have to do now is go to the menu here and say render oscillator A warp. This renders out all the different states here to the wavetable. So you can see we have a lot of wavetables here, a lot of cycles from one end to the other. And somewhere in the middle here, we have our regular phase signal. And all we have to do now is export this as a wave, bend plus minus wave. And that's it. We go back to the grid here and use another wavetable. And we just drop in this wavetable we just generated into this thing here. And now we can basically iterate through all the stages of the warp mode. We can put this in here. You can see it. So you can see we can just change the phase signal. It looks a bit different, but we just fixed this now. So we go back here to the level and switch the signal to unipolar. And then we need the phase modifier here and reverse the signal. When we restart this, and when we press here some keys, you can see we have nearly the same signal. It's the same signal. So instead of using this now, we're using this. Okay. As you can see, when we now play here our wavetable, we still have the regular sine wave. But when we iterate over the wavetable here, we can bend now our wavetable. So when you go here to some, let's use some crawls, something like this. Maybe use an ADSR and an out and just test this out. So So this way, over the trick of with the wavetable here as a phase signal, we can basically export every single warp mode from Serum or other wavetable synthesizers, just and bring this in into the grid. So not only is the wavetable nice for having oscillator shapes, we can also use it to simulate or emulate certain techniques to change or modify the phase. Okay, so this is a small trick. Also works, of course, with the regular sine oscillators here. There's just one small problem, as you can see here. So it looks like the cycle is not clean inside the wavetable oscillator here. I don't know what the problem is. If it's maybe it's a problem of the export or the import, I don't know. I figured this out, but this is a way of using these algorithms inside the grid. So yeah, I hope this was pretty helpful for you, actually, how you can use the wavetable oscillator for changing sounds, not only for creating sounds. And you can probably imagine that there is a lot of more stuff to discover inside the grid with the new oscillator here in the grid. And I'm pretty happy about the future and all the new additions in Bitwig Studio 3.3, actually. So if you have some questions, then please leave a comment, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching, and bye.